What are some of the different tools then that I could use to start down this path? Like, you know, is it something that I can use Unity and start like writing C sharp, or you know, what tools is it that I can start to use if I want to begin exploring this path?
That's a great question, and I have the opinionated version of my answer and not opinionated. So the opinionated one is use WebXR because web is cool. And also it has other advantages being free for everybody. But the most popular tools right now is Unity with C sharp. And they have the most developers because they're also coming from the game development world. And the other tools that are coming up are Unreal Engine, which I really like. It's also very much like Unity. It has a UI, but also you can write C++ code. And it has both of these tools now have node-based programming, which means that you have these boxes, which represent some variables or other things, and then you can connect them together to write the code without having to worry about the syntax. And other than that, for mobile devices, you can write, you know, Kotlin or Java for Android, or you can use iPhones or iOS devices, augmented reality capabilities using their tools as well. Swift, I think, yeah.
Oh, interesting. So iOS has its own APIs then for doing some form of mixed reality. Does Android do that as well?
Yes, and they have more naming convention, AR Core and AR Kit. And it's really hard for me to remember. Android is AR Core and iOS is AR Kit. So they're augmented reality capabilities.
Okay, APIs. Good. Yeah, more names. That was exactly what I was hoping for here, because there wasn't enough.
That's what you need. But don't run away. It's so much easier when you start writing JavaScript. So the advantage of JavaScript is you can actually write code with something like React Native, or right now Babylon.js is one of the libraries who is working on their own native library. You can write JavaScript and deploy it onto any device. One thing that all of these devices have in common, and that's the only thing, is to have access to a browser. And one of the issues with all of these other tools compared to WebXR is that you have to go through their development process plus their app store, right? For Android, iOS, or Unity, Unreal, maybe on a Windows store. For web, you don't have any of those, which is a huge advantage. But on the other hand, on the web, we are missing some of the capabilities for now. And the reason is on the web, we take things slow. We want to make things very secure, and we don't want to break any of our APIs. Nobody's code will break, hopefully, once we decide. With Unreal Engine and Unity, there's no backward compatibility. Your code breaks every time and things like that happen. So it's a little hassle. They're great tools, but you know, you have to know these trade-offs.
Okay. Trying to fix your screen here real quick. It went sideways on me. Give me 1 second here. Let me
no worries.
Try and see if I can't get this to refresh itself. Ah, there we go. Okay.
Yeah.
Cool. Yep. All right. We're back.
Yeah. Yay.
Much better. Cool. So, you know, you highlight, I think, one of the biggest things about like just web development in general is that this is pretty much as close as we can get to a write once run anywhere. That yes, obviously there's still, you know, different browser challenges and so forth that different browsers will do different things. But you know, to a certain extent, a lot of that does seem to have either been smoothed out, or if nothing else, that the frameworks will then handle that for us. So as long as I'm using a framework, then typically it's going to then manage all of those browser issues. And then you also highlight another real big part is that if it's, you know, just a website, then I don't need to worry about, you know, publishing out to the store and going through that approval process, which from everything that I've heard can really be a challenge.